cult can you now? That's where Polly is. Up there to the right is Bella, that's one of the sisters. That's family there. Sis. Gloria. There's the homestead there. Yeah, the family here. What Sis is going to do is display the genealogy sheet that we brought down from Walton.
Grateful to welcome you here on this set of pages. And there's been lots of photo, but perhaps this night is going to be a spiritual night where we can spend perhaps a little bit of spiritual moment in sharing with the whānau and with our friends and our home people as well. So to begin with, we'll sing the hymn already. And then after which we'll ask Gloria if she'd give us an opening prayer for her.
Oh, Father in heaven, we're grateful to be gathered here this evening in the presence of our beloved Polly, who has departed from our midst, and with our extended family. We're grateful for all those that are here to share this loving time with our mourning family, and we invite thy spirit, Father, to be with each and every one of us, and also with Bella, Reen and Pearl, and all the extended family, that we may feel of thy love, and that we may be comforted at this time. And we ask that thou would, and we invite thy spirit to be with us through this evening. And we say these things humbly in the name of thy Son, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Gloria, and I guess for me, I need to work with the Spirit, and thank you, Gloria, for inviting the Spirit to be with us. And so program is like a scout, BP, means be prepared. I just want to talk a little bit about things about David and Goliath. And perhaps the story of David, he was a very good boy. And in his childhood days, but he did everything his father did. And to the extent David was always looking after the sheep. And the brothers were always doing the business side of things. But poor old David, he was out in the hillside.
Two sisters, one in green,
and Pearl.
There's three girls. That's all that's left for Audrey's family.
But for David knew all his sheep. He probably knew how to talk to each and every one of them, just like how our mother talks to certain children in a certain way, just like your mother, how they speak to one another. But David was a
That's
very
Alex
man.
Bunnell. And he looked and so he much like Audrey's husband, Ben. Difficult
David
start, just
a
little build.
He,
the church member.
Well, looking after
and
the...
good orator. Very good.
After the sheep. He fought with a bear. And defended because the bear was coming eating sheep. I think he even fought against the lions. And that's how David spent 24/7 looking after his sheep. He was so good that he relied on something other than his own strength and his own knowledge about sheep. And he depended a lot upon his Heavenly Father. And so his Heavenly Father got to know David very, very well as well. And during this time there was this giant called Goliath. And he was going around fighting all these different people, different armies, and he was a warmonger. And he was beating up all these other people around the villages, and nobody in the end would fight against David until Goliath himself approached all these people and says, "Anybody want to fight me?" And David's father said that he's got a few sons that were game enough to fight him. And the sons themselves were not too confident to fight him. But David stepped forward and said he'll challenge Goliath. He wasn't fearful at all. David was just a whip of a man. And he came forward. And we all know how David killed Goliath. He got out his slingshot, and Goliath had all his armor and everything on. And David used the slingshot to kill Goliath. While Goliath was down on the ground, he pulled out Goliath's sword and chopped off his head. Now David, through doing that, became very, very famous. He became very, very famous amongst his people to the extent that they wanted to make him a bit of a ruler there. And so he became a ruler, still staying close to his heavenly Father. And one day, while he was at home, he looked out from his balcony and across the other side. He saw a lady who was bathing naked. Never before had seen David was. He wanted this lady. And somehow or other, he coerced this lady to his place. Can anybody tell me who the lady was? Bathsheba. The lady was Bathsheba. Very, very pretty lady. Was the lady married or was she single?
Married, yeah.
She was married. Now, you see what's happening here. Because of David's faithfulness as well, something little happened. He saw her across there and he wanted that lady. And he sent his servants to go and get her, and she came. And he liked her so much that he wanted to have her for himself. He loved her so much that he put Bathsheba's husband in the front line of the battle so he would be killed. Was he killed in that battle? No. He did all the pressures of the battle and he came back. But David had already made up his mind to the extent that he had to kill Bathsheba's husband. And there, from one little wrong to a greater sin, one little wrong led to another. And he committed one of the greatest sins there was adultery. And so David became very, very disheartened with himself, with his own disloyalty, to the extent that David wrote many, many psalms. In fact, he wrote most of the book of Psalms. And in the 22nd chapter of Psalms, we are quite familiar with the verse, it goes something like this. Yea, though I walk in the valley of the shadow of death, I fear no evil. They are with me. My rod and my staff defend me. Can anybody else help me? Thou preparest a table in the presence of my enemy. And then he said that the Lord had blessed him so much that his cup runneth over. David really loved the Lord, and he still to this day, David will never ever know that the Lord will forgive him. And so it is with us today. Holly was been a very, very good girl in her childhood. Everybody makes mistakes. Everybody tries to be perfect. And then, when we're about to return to meet our Maker, something happens to us. We want to repent. In David's case, he went to the grave with the thought that
Alex. He was a cousin to Billy, which was Audrey's husband.
Starting to die, and we are sent here to gain a body and to one day return to our Heavenly Father, being a lot more prepared than we ever came to this earth. And I so sympathize with David in his quest for repentance, and each of us have our own forms of life. I know that if we repent, our Heavenly Father will bless us. I pray that this message will be for us to take home and to think about those things, to ponder upon how would you think your Heavenly Father would say to you when you go back to the presence of our Heavenly Father. There are many of us that are good servants. But, I know that Polly has... done good as a mother and a sister and as a daughter.
A lot of the people have gone home now, so it's just a bare family that's still here with us.
But in our own mind, she knows what
this has got a program on that we need to see, and I'll show you that later on when she displays her stand. Amen.
Perhaps I could open up. We have 10 minutes to spend for the end of our clock here. To, for those who want to say something.
Just want to... thank you to all of you here who assembled here tonight, and it's for a special reason. The special reason I'm concentrating on is what has happened here tonight with my nieces and young Polly, who has passed away. And while contemplating what I would do with that, I want my girls to hold up this chart that came to me through as a birthday gift from someone over in the United States. Now, he had spent a whole year doing this whakapapa. And this whakapapa, he sent to me on my birthday. So when I heard that Polly had passed away, I was really impressed in here to come here, not only just to be here for you, but also to share this chart with you. And the reason I'm saying that is because you are all bereft of parents now. You don't have your parents here and you don't have your brothers here. And it must be a feeling that only you will know that it's a feeling of hopelessness or not any future ahead of you because your family has gone on. Would I be right? So when that thought came to me, I wanted to share this with you. And I wanted to share with you so that you can do a bonding tonight. That what I'm going to share with you, it's to do with your family. Those who have gone. And we're the living, we are here to promote this and explain it to you. Is that alright? Okay. Alright. I'm going to ask Donna and Gloria to hold up this chart, which has come over especially for my birthday, but it is the whakapapa on my mother's side and my father's side. And it's been done by a friend who has who served the mission here for the church many years ago.
I need to go around. Can I say that? There we go. Show it in person and swing it around to show. Come close.
in your spirit.
Vamos a reconocer.
So maybe you then need to
turn it around. Turn it back this way,
yeah.
So that they can see.
Take it around.
And we'll come back to you so you can see them. And then we'll walk you through it. We're going to show the hole.
Yeah.
If you have a look at this chart, it's been meticulously done by someone who's dedicated a whole year to this research. And this research here is to do with my mother's side, here on my ear, and my mother's side, and here on my ear, this is my father's side. Now, all my siblings and I can just put our own names on there, and that whakapapa is exactly the same. Okay? Now, these precious children here, who are my sister's children, their parents will appear on that chart. So I want them to know that their parents that are on this chart are those who have passed on, and there are those who will be sealed to you. All right? They will be sealed to you at the Holy Temple down in Hamilton. So this message for you is to let you know that you are not bereft without them. They are there. All they want for you is to come together and still be family and look forward to this great time. And what I want you to get out of that is a feeling that all is not lost. Even though Polly's gone, she's not really gone. She's still here. All right? Sometimes we see death like that, that it's the end, but it's not the end. It's only moved on. It's like when we are born, we will all be born at different times. We go through a path where that's going to open a door for us to do certain things. And so this whakapapa here is to do with my mother's side. Superimposed on that is the Tainui canoe. All right? And on there, on that waka, are the captains, and I'm not sure who the others are, but it is the Tainui canoe that our origin is from. So down there on that little spot, there's a yellow spot down there, which is my name. Your mother's name, Bella, and Irina and Pearl, goes down there. All right? And underneath her comes you, and you, Irina, and you, Pearl. That's just how it goes. Whether you want to see something that'll come out of that, I'm not going to explain anything. Because it's up to you to search for that yourself. And I want to leave that message with you so that you will not be bereft through the loss of your sister. Let it be a time to be happy that she's not in pain anymore. But she's not lost to us. We are inhumanely sad because she's not here. But we can all more grieve for that, but don't let it carry on. Because they will come together. Now, our job is to fill in these spaces here because they're couples. Okay? These red color-coded are couples that we're going to actually find out who these people are. Your parents, who are they? Where were they born? When do they die? How many children did they have? How many mokopuna they have? That's your job. Okay? And so that brings hope to you, brings hope to all of us here. This is what life is about. And so we want to show that to you, and perhaps we're trying to get it now laminated so that you can have a copy. You can have a copy for you to work out for yourself. We all have to do that for ourselves, all of us. And it's your job to do that. So our message tonight to you, sweetheart, is to give you hope. Just tell you there's nothing else we can give you tonight but our great love for your family, those who've gone on. Your brothers, your mum and dad, and I know they're sitting in here tonight waiting for you and helping you to listen and to understand what we're saying tonight. If you've got any questions, you ask these girls here. They'll answer the questions.
These are parental lines. Okay, so these are not issue. These are parental lines. So it's
all of Mum's brothers and sisters that sit on that yellow line, and then her parents, and then they go back parental lines. No children after that. So that's how this whakapapa has been designed. Of course, if we were to fit all the children in it, there wouldn't be enough space. So they follow parental lines. And on the Reti side, it goes back as far as 837 in Tahiti. In Tahiti. And so we, you know, we have another link here. So that's, you know, the hapu of Mum's whānau. So that's Ngāti Whawhake was a man's name. Whawhake was a man's name. So he's mentioned here, yeah, on Mum's line, on Nana's line. So we're going to delicately spread this out. I think we'll use those seats there so that you can see it. Please try not to touch it too much. So at the moment I have taken it to a few experts to see if we can get it copied. And then, because it's of the size that it is, it is industrial, so it's building plan size. So that's a different copier. So the local copying systems don't cater for this size. So it has to go to another level, more industrial, or as Auntie Charlotte was saying, more catered for at the universities. But that's been my mission, is to try and get it protected by having it copied, so that it can go to all of our whānau for you, and then to have it laminated.
And you can put that up on your wall in your house.
And you can laminate it yourself, but it's to get it, first of all, copied. So it is quite a priceless keepsake. The paper is unusual, so it's just trying not to put too many marks on it, and just to maintain that protection. So, but I think it's good while we're here for you to talk about it and to see where it all links together. You'll be talking for hours.
What I'd like to do now is to have Bella express what it feels like for her knowing this now, and perhaps for you too, Irene and Phil. What does it mean to you tonight at a time when we are about to with your sister, to let her go? How would you feel about this that's happening now?
I think I can speak for both of my sisters. Very emotional about this. In my heart, it's jumping with joy because it gives me wings. Whakapapa is very important, and I have pursued some, and not nearly like. Sharing your time with us. Okay. And my
I sing a song? It's that Do the Lord's Prayer in Maori.
We're going to have a song now, and Donna and those of you who know that will sing it.
You have to wait.
Lord's Prayer. Lord's Prayer.
Yeah.
Tomato,